I'm Sophie K for Total Rock Radio, joined by Kris. Hello.
Hello.
Kris from Dommin. Now tell me, Dommin's your surname, is that correct?
Correct.
So I'm guessing the band was your vision.
Yeah.
Is that right?
It was kind of one of those things where I'm really kind of tedious about everything when it comes to the band.
Mm.
Every minute little detail. And so when it came to me thinking about a name for it, it was like the worst, most daunting task ever. And so it was one of those things where it was like, well, I can't think of anything that would, you know, because when you put a title on something, you want it to really represent you.
Yeah.
And so it was one of those things where I was like, what's the one thing that's constant about Dommin? Me.
Your love in my heart.
There's quite an element of swing to your music, for example,
you
in
noticed.
Dark Holiday. Yeah.
Okay.
You look shocked at that.
Well, a lot of people would never even use the word swing.
Yeah, and, well, definite swing.
Did. Yeah.
Where did that inspiration come from?
I'm a big fan of old, like, jazz music, like the classic Sinatra kind of stuff. So everything that kind of has that swing vibe to, like, rockabilly type stuff. And so, you know, when you put all that together with everything else that I'm influenced by, I mean, I love those beats. You know, I think on probably the next album there's going to be a lot more of that. But
excited.
You know, yeah. So, I mean, it's just, you know, I figure every band is kind of like a cocktail of what they like, plus whoever, you know, is writing has their own personality in it. And that's kind of what we are. It's just, you know, I'm influenced by a lot of different things. I like a lot of different types of genres and stuff.
Is there any Danzig in your cocktail?
Oh, of course.
Who else did you put in your cocktail?
I don't think that's, you know, hard to see.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, for as far as, like, rock and, like, metal bands and stuff, I grew up on Kiss and AC/DC.
Mm.
When I started finding my own bands that I would like, because I grew up on those bands because my dad and my older brother were always playing them.
Yeah.
And then when I got my guitar, I was, like, a big Metallica fan. And then I started getting into Danzig and Typo, and I'm still a big Rammstein fan. Mm. But then, yeah, like, a lot of the stuff I listen to on a daily basis is, like, old crooner music. Yeah, it was the weirdest thing. There was a guy we were playing in San Francisco, and we were opening up for Combi Christ. So it was a real kind of, like, industrial crowd. You know, nobody knew who we were. We were the first band on. We're the opener that nobody cares about. And I had this guy come up to me, and he was like, I really hear, like, a Stray Cat Sinatra kind of thing coming out of your music. And I was like, really?
That's going to be a phenomenal compliment.
Yeah. Oh, it was huge. Because I was like, first of all, we're, like, rocking out on stage playing heavy music with, like, keyboards and synths and giant bells and choirs and stuff that, you know.
Mm.
And somebody pulls out Stray Cats and Sinatra. And I was like, how did that come across? He's like, it's just in the way you perform on stage. I'm like, really?
Are you quite open about the influences behind the writing of your song? Because you describe yourself as a storyteller, don't you?
Yeah, for me, all these songs are like little snippets, little moments in life.
Mm.
You know, it's just someone took a picture of what happened there, and this song is just a little emotional picture of what was happening at a certain point in time.
And are you able to tell us, My Heart, Your Hands, what that's about, or are you quite secretive to the actual event that inspired it?
I'm really not secretive. I wonder if I should be, because I hope I don't ruin it for anybody when I tell them the meaning of the song, because I really want people to relate to it in whatever way they can. But I'm not shy about saying what it's about. I mean, it was basically a new girl that I was going out with, and we were at a bar of all places, and I saw her, like, kiss somebody right in front of me. It was like a brand new relationship, and it was kind of like she didn't know I was looking or watching. And
was it, like, just the two of you out?
It was just the two of us out. She had some friends there, and apparently, like, an ex was there or something.
Mm.
And so I really was just like, you know, when something's new and it kind of goes from that, okay, I'm dating this person, to where I'm like, oh, I'm really starting to feel something. Like, this is probably going to suck. It's going to hurt if it goes bad, kind of thing. And sure enough, like, I was there, and I saw that. Because it was just like this irrational, overwhelming feeling of falling and feeling like literally I was in the palm of this girl's hands, and I just kind of felt her fingers closing around me.
You do nothing, no, you don't do nothing, yeah. Now it's going on, your love is gone. Without you, your love is gone.
And the things that tend to have that kind of impact on me to make me hurt or angry or happy or whatever it is love and the relationships that you have with people, whether it's a significant other or whether it's your mom and dad or what, or your brother or sister or a friend or whatever it is. It's those personal relationships, I think, that stand the test of time. But I think subconsciously I'm getting people's attention, and I'm trying to pull them in, and I'm trying to be epic and cinematic about it, you know what I mean? Because I want to say, hey, like, listen to what I'm doing, you know, let me draw you in, let me take you, let me tell you this story.